Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and today we're going to look at how we can use constructors to, if you like, preset values in our Java classes. We'll also look at how we can overload these constructors so we can have multiple constructors that provide different functionality. As always, you can find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. If you're on Twitter, you can follow me at theurbanpenguin and you'll find my Facebook page as theurbanpenguin. So we're starting off then, as you can see, with a new class that we've got here that we're defining. So nothing very much in it, it's within the package JVP, and we've got our class vehicle. Within the class we're defining a field that is a string value called color. So this is defined at the class level, so it's available to everything within that class. We can see now that using public vehicle we're now creating a constructor, and we're saying when we create an instance of the vehicle class we must pass a string through to the vehicle class. If we don't provide a constructor, the default constructor, the default no arguments constructor, is provided from the inheritance model, which is coming from our object class. So we're accepting the string argument and passing it through to our field color, making the constructor public is making it available to any class that wants to create an instance of our vehicle. So we know what's been set in our field. We might as well print something out because we're not going to do a lot else with it, just so we can see what's been set. So the color is, and then concatenate it with our field color. Don't you love my mix and match of spelling? So we've got American spelling of color in the text, but our field is UK. Don't you love consistency? So swapping over to my class here, you can see that we've changed over to the vClient class. And this is going to be my runnable client, so it's got the main method. And I'm creating a new instance of the vehicle, so I'm calling that instance V1, new vehicle, and then we're passing the parameter blue through it. So yeah, this vehicle is going to have the color blue. We wouldn't be able to create an instance of the vehicle class without passing the parameter through. And of course then we can see now the sysoutprint line that then is specifying, yeah, okay, our color is blue. So here we have a single constructor, but we can overload our constructors. All we're saying with that is that we can have multiple constructors with the same name that accept a different amount of arguments or accept different primitives through. So if I go through and duplicate this one, we'll accept a two argument vehicle constructor as well. So we've got public vehicle string C, so that was our original one, but I'm going to add in a new field level, or a new class level field, so we'll set the number of wheels, so int wheels. And in our second constructor we'll accept two arguments, so we're just comma separating the arguments. And the second argument we accept is going to be called wheels, and that's going to be an integer. To save us duplicating too much code, our larger constructors generally will call the smaller constructors because they've got everything that is needed. So to do that, I use this.c. So we take the color argument through and pass it through to the same constructor, but just the single argument constructor. Now we want to look at the additional argument. I'm just going to rename that so it's a little more normal, so int w, and then we'll set our wheels feel. We're going to assign it the value of our argument W. So now we can create instances of our vehicle class by providing a single string or a string and an integer. We're going to print out an additional message. We'll still get the first message printing out, but additionally we're going to print out how many wheels that we have. So calling the smaller constructor, this C, is going to print out the colour. But if we've got wheels, obviously we want to say the number of wheels that we have. So this is overloading our constructors. We've got two constructors with the same name, but they do slightly different tasks. So now if we go back to my client, we're in the class VClient, and we're going to create now a second instance of the vehicle. So we've got V1 and V2. When we create V2, we're going to pass the string and the int value to it. So we'll have wheels and colour. And we can have a red three-wheeler here. So now as I go through and execute from Eclipse, we're being prompted to save, but we see, yeah, the colour is blue, the colour is red, and we have three wheels relating then to our second object. Thank you. And hopefully you found this useful.